Hello friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here on Tips to Fix, and today we have very interesting video to do. Today I will speed up a website and I will show you all methods that you have to do to speed up your WordPress site. Okay, if your WordPress is running very slow and you see my processor here is 100% and you try to open up the homepage, you see it's loading and loading here at home, and you see here on the cPanel, you will see here the processor is 100% used, and also the RAM is more than 62% in use. So what do we gotta do today? I will try to speed up this website as much as possible. First of all, what do we gotta do? Let's do some changes on the hosting control panel. The first thing that I suggest to clients and first thing that I suggest to my friends is that you go here on the cPanel control panel where your website is hosted and go on PHP my editor, okay? PHP in editor or PHP manager. That come here on this multi-PHP manager, and what I gotta do, you see I'm using PHP 7.4. I highly recommend it using a 7 and up, more than 7, 7.1.4, you know. And here, choose the right PHP version. You click it here and click apply. But I already have PHP 7, okay? So let's go back. And also here is PHP 8, but I will use this one. 7.4 is great for me. And now on here on in multi-PHP editor, just click here and then choose this website, Club.fm, in my case. And what I gotta do, I will extend this one, maximum input time, I will put it on the 60. And this maximum execution time, I will put it 300 here, yes, as it is. And this one said the maximum number of input variables, I will change it and make it 10,000, okay? Memory limit, I highly recommend it, use it 2 GB, but in my case, I will use 4 GB, okay? And post maximum size, you can change it here if you want to post bigger sizes. And then now just click apply. Okay, let's see a little, let's go back here on a cPanel. And another thing that you have to do, scroll down, go down here, optimize the website. Okay, here this one is disabled, but what you're going to do, just click enable it and click update. And this one, it will optimize your website, it will compress all the content, it helps the website to speed up. Okay, this is the second thing that I do, is let's see if we need to disable anything here. I need this plugin, I need this one, I need them all, I think. I'm trying to remove some plugins that we don't really need, okay? Okay, I will deactivate this one because I don't need it. And also I will delete this. I don't need this plugin. We need contact form, advanced editor. We need that advanced editor. It's great because some journalists need that advanced editor to edit content on the website before they publish it. The next thing that we have to do, we have to install a cache plugin. That's really important. It speed up your processor. So mostly used W3 total cache that you can install it if you want, and then it will speed up your WordPress. In fact, I will use LightSpeed cache plugin because my server support. So if your server support LightSpeed here, my server support it because it's here is installed. It's LightSpeed web cache manager. And then now I will install the plugin on the website. Install this LightSpeed cache now. 3 million active installations, okay? Okay, I will click activate it here right now, and then you will see the website will perform really fast. Okay, now as you activate it, let's try to open up the website, and you will see it will perform faster here. Go to dashboard again. You see it's faster now. It is much faster than it was. You go to media. Look at this. Wow. Look at this. It's opening very fast. Look. Okay, great. It's faster. Go to dashboard. Oh, I will see the processor now. Let's scan here. Let's go back here on the home. We'll try to refresh the host. And the work of processor, the CPU usage now, it's 13%. Wow. The CPU is breathing now. The website is working really fast for the moment. Go back here. And what I gotta do, just go here on the plugins again. No, I will go here on the LightSpeed cache. And we will see here that what we have to change. Let's go on a general. And here on the general, what I gotta do, I will just request a domain key. Click this button. And then you will wait a little. And then this website will accept our website. You can create here a quick cloud profile and then sign in. And I will add a new domain here. Let's go here on general domain key. Here it is, link to quick.cloud. And let's click continue. And then you will see that this website will be here on the list right now. Just right click and you will see it here. Okay, but use it, test it, and let me know if it works for you. Also, it will support image optimization. It's very important that it can optimize your images in the real time, and it will make your website to load really fast. So that's it with this. Next thing, what I suggest you to do, you have to disable wp-cron job from WordPress, because every time that somebody open up the website, then this wp-cron job on WordPress will eat a lot of processor. So how you do this? Go here on your host provider, go on the control panel, file manager, and then I'm here on the cPanel control panel. What I gotta do, I will just go on the wp-config and I will edit it. Here on the WordPress, you don't have to see those things here at all, because you can hack my website. Okay, so what you gotta do, just copy this command here, put it here in the end of this line, disable wp-cron true here, and then I will enable this on the host. This will help the website. Click save changes. Refresh. I will go here on the cron, search for cron jobs here. So what we got to do here on the cron job, we just copy and paste this command that I will paste on the description and you will get it, and then replace this domain here with yours. Okay, copy and paste your domain name. Okay, look at this. Is this okay? Nice. I will do this every once per hour, no minute, but hour here. No, twice, but once per hour. Add new cron job. Make sure you do this right, like I did on your hosting provider. And then let's refresh the page. And the website is very fast now. So open up GT metrics and let's test the website again. And let's see the speed. Look at this, 1.5 seconds. Man, it's amazing. We didn't see this before. Now it's much faster. So another thing that I do, I really recommend to you for your website to be faster, is use CloudFlare, okay? It's very important, CloudFlare. Let's go on CloudFlare and let's, if you don't have it, just create an account, but I will log in on a CloudFlare and then I will see here if this website is on the CloudFlare. You see this website, it's on the CloudFlare, and you see the traffic and you see everything here. If you don't know how to use CloudFlare and how to add your website on CloudFlare, I will make another video tutorial and I will suggested here on the end of this video, okay? Put your domain here on the DNS, on the Cloudflare, and replace your name servers on the domain control panel, okay? I will show you in another video. But make sure you use Cloudflare. And for the security SSL, let's go here, and then I will use full. And now the SSL certificate is handled Cloudflare. So now the website is really fast and also is more secure. You see the structure is, performance is 46%. The largest container is 1.5 seconds. But let's see here on GT metrics what's going on. Look at this. And I highly recommend it. Do not post photos like 1.4 megabytes or 2 megabytes a photo. This is crazy. This will damage your speed, your SEO, your Google suggestion website and everything. Don't keep that much because this is very large for this. Let's open up and see this. Look at this image. So what you got to do, is before you upload a photo on your website, you better change the quality. So what you got to do, just open up this image. I found something very cool here on GitHub and I really like that. If you go to my account and if you go to stars here, and what I did, I fork here this web to JPEG online. I really like this website. If you go here online in this one, it will help a lot to convert your photos on desired format. WebP is very good for your photos to keep it on the web because it will increase the speed of your website because the size are very small and quality very high. Let's see it. I have here 1.4 megabyte photo as I show you this one. What I gotta do, I just have to save this photo on the desktop for the moment. I know I have a bunch of files on the desktop, so don't laugh with me, guys. Come on, just give it save here. I will drag and drop this photo, bring it here, and it will be converted on a WebP. But I will change this format. I will do it JPEG, and I need to make the quality 60%. And I will do this auto and everything out, okay? Now, let's drag and drop the photo.
Job's done.
I will download it here, the photo. And let's see the size of the photo now. JPEG. Look, the size is 100 kilobyte. Great, great job. Now, instead of using 1.4 megabyte a photo on your website, convert it before. Use the converter. I will paste the link on the description and then use the converter. Convert the photo and use it on your website, okay? And another thing is keep your WordPress up to date. See for updates. I forgot something. Just delete the themes that you don't use. Look at this. Why do I have to keep this? Delete it, man. I don't want to have it here. Bye-bye. I only need to have the theme that I'm using. Okay? So, guys, if you have any other questions or something, just ask me on the comment area. I did this video tutorial today to help you increase the speed of your website. Don't forget to subscribe, tips to fix, and share this content, this video with your friends, and let's help others, help them all. I hope I help you today, and God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial. Bye-bye.